ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय So again today we'll be reading from Bhagavad Gita, chapter 7 and text again today we are going to read 15. So repeat after me. Namam duskirtino mudha prapadyante naradhamah Mayaya pahrita jnanam Asuram bhavam asritah I will read translation and then remaining purport on the page 337. First I am reading translation. Those miscreants who are grossly foolish, who are lowest among mankind, whose knowledge is stolen by illusion, and who partake of the atheistic nature of demons, don't surrender unto me. And purport I will start. In my book it is 337 page and second paragraph. Next page and in this verse Krishna talks about some duskriti, means sinful person, sinner. There are four different types and duskriti, sinner, they don't surrender unto lotus feet of Krishna. Out of four, one is Muddha, which yesterday we have already discussed. Second, Naradhama, lowest among mankind. And third is Maya Apahrita Jnana. And fourth is Asuram Bhavma Asrita. So yesterday we have already discussed about Muddha, foolish. Out of their foolishness, they don't take shelter in the lotus feet of Krishna. And today, another class of duskriti, another class of duskriti or miscreants is called the naradhama or lowest of mankind. Naradhama is human being and nar means human being and adham means lowest. Out of 8,400,000 different species of living being, there are 400,000 human species. Out of these, there are numerous lower forms of human life that are mostly uncivilized. The civilized human beings are those who have regulative principles of social, political and religious life. Those who are socially and politically developed but who have no religious principles must be considered Naradhamas. Nor is the religion without God religion, because the purpose of following the religious principle is to know the supreme truth and man's relation with him. In the Gita, the personality of Godhead clearly states that there is no authority above him and that he is the supreme truth. The civilized form of human life is meant for man's reviving the lost consciousness of his eternal relation with the supreme truth, the personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna, who is all powerful. Whoever loses this chance is classified as Naradhama. We get information from revealed scriptures that when the baby is in the mother's womb, an extremely uncomfortable situation, he prays to God for deliverance and promise to worship him alone as soon as he gets out. To pray to God when he is in the difficulty is a natural instinct in every living being because he is eternally related with God. But after his deliverance, the child forgets the difficulty of birth and forgets his deliverer also, being influenced by Maya, the illusory energy. It is the duty of the guardians of children to revive their divine consciousness dormant in them. The 10 process of reformatory ceremony as enjoined in the Manusmriti, which is guide to religious principles, are meant for reviving God consciousness in the system of Varnashram. However, no process is strictly followed now in any part of the world, and therefore 99.9% of the population is Naradhama. When the whole population becomes Naradhama, naturally all their so-called education is made null and void of the all-powerful energy of the physical nature. According to the standard of the Gita, a learned man is he who sees on equal terms the learned brahmanas, the dog, the cow, and the elephant, and the dog-eater. That is the vision of a true devotee. Sri Nityananda Prabhu, who is the incarnation of the Godhead as Divine Master, delivered the typical Naradhama, the brothers Jagai and Madhai, and showed how the mercy of the real devotee is bestowed upon the lowest of mankind. So the Naradhama, who is condemned by the personality of Godhead, can again revive his spiritual consciousness only by the mercy of a devotee. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in propagating the Bhagavat Dharma, our activity of the devotee, has recommended that people submissively hear the message of the personality of Godhead. The essence of the message is Bhagavad Gita. The lowest among human beings can be delivered by the submissive hearing process. submissive hearing process only. But unfortunately, they even refuse to give an oral reception to these messages, and what to speak of surrendering to the will of the Supreme Lord. Naradhamas are the lowest of mankind, willfully neglect the prime duty of the human being. So the second type of duskritini, duskritinah, duskriti is described that the narathama. Prabhupada in this purpose talks about, and there are 8,400,000 species of life. Out of that, only 400,000, 4 lakh, the human being. 84 lakh, out of 84 lakh, only 4 lakh species of human being is there. So, out of this 4 lakh variety of human being, everyone is not civilized. There are some civilized and there are some uncivilized. Prabhupada in this purpose talks about civilization means, in a civilized society, human society, there is a regulative principles in a social life and in political life. There are some regulatory governing principles there. Religious principle, social principle, political principle. In a civilized one, and there are some human beings, they are not civilized. They have not any principle, uncivilized. And among the civilized, some people, some human beings, they have a regulatory principle in the field of social life and political life. But when comes religious principle, they have no any idea, religious principle. So, the person, the society where is no religious principle, they are called here Naradhamas. Because actual religion, religious life, purpose of religion, religious principle is to know Krishna God. Purpose of religious principle. There are some civilized society, religious principle is there, and the religious principle is it is for knowing Krishna God, and same time reviving its lost relation with Krishna. Two purpose. One purpose, to know Krishna. Religious principle meant to know Krishna, and same time revive our lost eternal relation with Krishna. So some people, they are not civilized, and since they have not a religious principle, they miss the opportunity. They don't know, they are not able to know Krishna, the absolute truth. And same time, they also miss the opportunity to revive their relation with Krishna. So those type of people, they are called Naradhama. Naradham means in the society there is no. So since there is no any religious principle, so they do anything and everything. There is no dharma vichar, that constitution of dharma. And here in this purport, Srila Prabhupada talked about two typical Naradhama, Jagai and Madhai. So Prabhupada here said, even Naradhama, they could be uplifted, lifted on the platform of civilization, and they could be delivered. Because a saintly person, highly learned personality, pandit, he does not make distinction between civilized and uncivilized. Srila Prabhupada here talks about even a devotee should try his level best to deliver even the Naradhamas. Like Nityananda Prabhu, he delivered Jagai and Madhai. And Prabhupada talks about the real vision, learned, who is a real, real learned personality. Here Prabhupada is in purport, Vidya Vinay Sampane Brahmane Gavi Hastini Suni Chaiva Sopake Cha Pandita Samadarsinam. By virtue of true understanding, true knowledge, a learned person sees with equal vision, Vidya Vinay Sampane Brahman, with the the virtue of true knowledge, he gets qualification, he is eligible to see Brahman, Brahmane, Gavi, elephant, Brahmane, Hastini, cow, elephant, dog, and even a dog eater with equal vision, by the virtue of knowledge. So a devotee, even he finds some person, Naradham, completely ignorant, he has doesn't follow any religious principle, he is not aware the purpose of his life. Purpose of human form of life or purpose of religious principle is to know, understand, realize the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, God. And same time, he must try his level best to revive his eternal Shashwat Sabandha with Krishna. So he doesn't know, but a devotee, he tries his level best to deliver even the Naradhamaj. So here Prabhupada in this purport quote about Jagai and Madhai, they were delivered by Nityanand Prabhu, by the mercy of Lord Nityanand Prabhu. So their duskriti, due to their sinful activity, they have those miscreants, those people usually on their own, they don't take shelter in the lotus feet of Krishna, they don't surrender. Their only hope, how they could be delivered, the only hope is the mercy of a devotee. And also in Parapasila Prabhupada, how they would be delivered if they hear the message of Srimad Bhagavad Gita, Vedic literature, by a devotee, by lips of devotee, if the devotee describing, presenting the message of Bhagavad Gita, Vedic knowledge, and if someone hears, even Naradhama hears, very easily he can revive his Krishna consciousness. So, even Naradhamas, they could be delivered by the mercy of Krishna, by the mercy of devotee. So, second type of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Srila Prabhupada talks about Naradhama, the uncivilized. In their society, they don't have any religious principle. And so they don't follow anything, they don't have real concept what is the papa and what is punya, what is pious activity and sinful activity. So they do anything and everything and they lose the opportunity to surrender at the lotus feet of Krishna. They don't surrender. Third type of, in this verse Krishna talks about, mayaya aphrita jnana. There are some person, maya means by the maya, illusion, illusory potency of Krishna, aparit means stolen jnana, whose knowledge is stolen by maya. They also don't surrender. Usually, materially, with material consideration, they are very learned scholar, pandit, jnani. But since maya, illusory potency of Krishna has spoiled their knowledge is no more effective because it is directly aparita, means stolen. Real knowledge is taken away and whatever they know material, they are very scholar, philosopher, but since that it is twisted in such a way where they don't come to the proper conclusion of surrendering Krishna, mean their knowledge. Maya pahrita jnana. So what they do? They, when talks about Krishna, they think that Krishna, the God, is also, first of all, they don't consider. But when we talk about Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, they say, hey, Krishna was also an ordinary human being like us. So they derive, they don't recognize that Krishna's form was transcendental form. Though he appeared like human being, but his body was completely transcendental. He came with transcendental body. So they don't give the proper respect or proper understanding for the forms of the Krishna. Srila Prabhupada in this purpose talks about the human life is, let me first read this, I didn't thought. The next class of duskriti is called Maya Pahrita Jnanam, or those person whose erudite knowledge has been nullified by the influence of illusory material energy, they are mostly very learned fellows, great philosopher, poets, literati, scientists, etc. But the illusory energy misguides them and therefore they disobey the Supreme Lord. There are a great number of Maya Pahrita Jnana at the present moment, even among the scholars of Bhagavad Gita. In the Gita, in plain and simple language, it is stated that Sri Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. There is none equal to or greater than him. He is mentioned as the father of Brahma, the original father of all human beings. In fact, Sri Krishna is said to be not only the father of Brahma, but also the father of all species of life. He is the root of the impersonal Brahman and Paramatma, the Super Soul, in every entity, in every entity is his plenary portion. He is the fountainhead of everything, and everyone is advised to surrender unto his lotus feet. Despite all these clear statements, the Maya Pahrita Jnana derided the personality of the Supreme Lord and considered him merely another human being. They don't know that blessed form of the human life is designed after the eternal and transcendental feature of the Supreme Lord. And the unauthorized interpretation of the Gita by the class of the Maya Pahrita Jnana outside the preview of the parampara system are so many stumbling blocks on the path of spiritual understanding. The deluded interpreters don't surrender unto lotus feet of Sri Krishna, nor do they teach others to follow the principle. The third type of duskriti. Here Prabhupada, Maya Apahrita Jnana. Usually in this category comes, they are learned scholar, no doubt. They know the Vedic literature. But their knowledge is completely spoiled by Maya. And so they don't come to the proper conclusion. Here Srila Prabhupada in this purpose talks about even there are some scholar, they know Bhagavad Gita, they comment on Bhagavad Gita, Vedic literature. But when comes about Krishna, the personality of Godhead, they don't give proper respect for Krishna. Balki they say criticize. Under in Vedic literature, in Bhagavad Gita, Srila Prabhupada, frankly it is described that Krishna is the supreme personality of Godhead. Krishna stu Bhagavan Swayam. In Vedic literature. But they don't accept this fact. First of all, Krishna is also ordinary human being. Even the scholar of Gita, Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, completely describe the Brahmaro hi pratishtaham. I am source of Brahma Jyoti. Impersonal feature of Krishna, the Brahma Jyoti. Krishna personality, person Krishna is root cause of Brahma Jyoti, and he is source of super soul, Paramatma also. Vadanti tat vidas tattvam yaj jnanam advayam brahmeti brahmeti paramatmeti bhagavan iti shabde. So Krishna, the person Krishna is source of, root of Paramatma, source of Paramatma, origin of Paramatma, and same time impersonal Brahma Jyoti also. But they, knowledge is apahrita jnana, knowledge is stolen. They, even the scholar of Bhagavad Gita, they say, so-called scholar of Bhagavad Gita, they say that no, Brahma Jyoti, impersonal feature, is the absolute truth. And form of Krishna, personality, the emanation, they came out, emanation of the Brahma Jyoti. So, but they don't, so that is reason why in Vedic literature, Prabhupada here one talks about our form, it is designed, the human form, it is designed after the eternal transcendental feature of Supreme Lord. When Brahma was creating human body, so he first saw the Krishna. So similarly it is human body design. It means we have two arms, two legs. The similar feature personality Krishna is there. Man was made in image of God. Image of God is there. Man was made. Man is made up after image of God. So we have form. So when Brahma was creating human body, he was looking always how Krishna looks like. Thus, we are designed after the eternal and transcendental feature of Supreme Lord. So we have form, means Krishna has form. The absolute of reality has form. But since they are very philosopher, jnani, but their knowledge is spoiled by, nullified by the Maya. So they don't give proper, they derived even the form of Krishna. Namam duskritnu mudha prapadnante naradhama. So they don't surrender unto lotus feet of Krishna. So and since they don't follow, and then don't teach other also. If they themselves are not following, they don't give proper respect for the transcendental form of Krishna. So they're like deluged. Deluged means this type of scholar, Maya Pahirda Jnana, this type of sinner, Duskriti. What they do? They make someone to believe something which is not true. Since they are learned scholar, they use such a language, they try to make someone believe something which is not true. So this is a very dangerous characteristic they have developed. They always think that, so presenting different types of theory. they present something, they try to make us believe something which is not true. So this type of duskritinidhi, that's called maya pahrita jnana. And the fourth one, the last class of duskriti is called asuram bhavam asrita. One who has developed asura bhav, demoniac nature, are those of demoniac principle. The class is openly atheistic. This class is openly atheistic. Some of them argue that the Supreme Lord can never descend upon this material world, but they are unable to give any tangible reason as to why not. There are others who make him subordinate to the impersonal feature, although the opposite is declared in the Gita. Envious of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the atheist will present a number of illicit incarnations manufactured in their factory of his brain. Such person whose very principle of life is to decry the personality of Godhead can't surrender unto the lotus feet of Krishna. Sri Jamunachar Alvardaru of South India said, "O my Lord, you are unknowable to person involved with atheistic principle, despite your uncommon qualities, features and activities, despite your personalities being confirmed by all the revealed scriptures in the quality of goodness, and despite your being acknowledged by the famous authorities, renowned for their depth of knowledge in the transcendental science and situated in the godly qualities. Therefore, one grossly foolish person, the lowest of mankind, the deluded speculators, and the professed atheist, as above mentioned, never surrendered unto the lotus feet of the Personality of Godhead. In spite of all scriptural and authoritative evidence." So the fourth class, Rupa is talking about asuram bhavam asrita. They have developed demoniac nature, swabhav. In Bhagavad Gita, one of the 16th chapter, Krishna talks about characteristics of asura bhav. Dambho darpu bhimanascha krodha parushya mevacha ajnanam chabhijatasya partha sampada asuri. There are many, but it will be few of characteristic of asuram bhava masrita. one who has taken shelter in asura bhav, or who have developed asuric nature, asuric swabhav. Dambh means hypocrisy. Their position is something else, but they try to show. They are various called. They are foolish, but they try to show them. That called dambh, hypocrisy in there. Darp means arrogance. They are very much arrogant in their behavior and dealing with people in general. Abhiman, pride. They are very much proud of their knowledge or anything. Krodh. They are very angry. Always very much krodh. And parushya. Harsh. They speak harsh word. which hurt your, when you listen, it is very, it hurt your heart. So, dambha, hypocrisy, darp, pride, or arrogance, and abhiman, pride and arrogance, the same. Krodh, always angry, and harsh word they use, especially their whole dealing in the harsh way. Word they use, harsh word. Ajnanam chabhita says, and ignorance. Partha sampada asurim. These are the property, their wealth of asuras. So here, fourth one, asuram bhavama asrita. Since they have developed asura bhava, demoniac nature, they don't surrender unto lotus feet of Krishna. And and try their level best to make someone to believe something which is not true. Even the scholar of so-called, there who has nothing, they don't come in the parampara system. So they try, there are many things they speak. They say that even a scholar, Vedic scholar, the ultimate reality is formless, impersonal. And that impersonal Brahma Jyoti is the source, cause of, root of personality of Krishna and Paramatma also. So this is, it's not true, but since they are deluded and they try to make us, make the society to believe something, this fact which is not true. So due to this, the Krishna talks about the four type of people. They are duskriti. There are four there are four category. They are all sinful person. Duskriti. They have committed sin in their previous life and this life. And they are muddha, they are foolish. Naradhama, not civilized. They don't have any knowledge about the principle of religion. They don't know the purpose of human form of life. And maya paritya jnana, whose knowledge is spoiled, by knowledge is stolen. Literature says their knowledge is completely stolen by illusory potency of Krishna. It is spoiled, their knowledge is completely spoiled. And who have developed asura bhava, demoniac nature, they don't surrender unto lotus feet of Krishna. Next verse talks about who surrenders then. This is a negative point. Who doesn't surrender? And then next verse talks about who surrenders unto lotus feet of Krishna. Duskriti don't surrender. And Sukriti, they surrender to lotus feet of Krishna. Chaturvidha bhajante mam jana sukritun arjuna artu jigyasu artharthi jnani cha bharsav. There are also four type of Sukriti, four type of Duskriti, who don't surrender, and four type of Sukriti, who have done, earned piety, and done pious activity, they surrender to lotus feet of Krishna. So here Krishna, very easy to remember. Muddha, Naradhama, Maya Pahrita Jnana, and Asuram Bhavam Asrita. Fools, grossly foolish person, lowest among mankind, whose knowledge is stolen by illusory Eden potency of Krishna, and one who has developed demoniac nature, demoniac swabhav, they don't surrender unto lotus feet of Krishna. Okay, see here I stop. If you have any question or comment, you are most welcome. Okay, sir. Srila Prabhupada ki.